If you're offended by the word balls, this might not be the video for you. What's up, everybody? It is I, Hero Vange, and welcome to the third episode of the Rose Cup Meta Simplified Guide. If you're on the wrong episode, if you haven't watched episode 1, episode 2, or you're looking for like a different episode, check out the playlist right there, alright? Just if the other episodes are not there yet, that means I haven't released them yet. But just be patient, they'll be out soon. In this episode, we're gonna cover the ghost types. Here we freaking go again! You forgot! What is that? Huh? I got my hater blockers on! What's up? Wow, dude. You look 10 times stupider, and you forgot Driftflame. I'm just embarrassed for you, alright? I'm leaving, okay? I'm gonna go to the J Farmacus channel, who actually makes good content, and he has Scrublord Dustin, and he's actually funny, alright? So, yeah, peace out. Big shouts out to the J Farmacus channel, and happy birthday, Scrublord Dustin. Guys, go to J Farm's channel and greet Scrublord Dustin a happy, happy birthday. It was his birthday when I recorded this, or like right now as I'm recording this. So let's say you were considering a ghost type that is not here, and you click on my video and you're offended once again. Where's my drift blim? All right. Basically, what you can do is you can follow along with the matchups that we do, and you can compare and contrast your ghost to these ghosts and see if it fits well on your team, if it's better compared to these guys, and if you find something that is better, it might be secret sauce. Let's start it off with the fighting type coverage plus Rhyperior. So very clear here is Medicham. Medicham, you can straight farm down. Just make sure to block once. Block once, you can farm it down with all three of these ghosts. Okay, with the buddy boost, without the buddy boost, just farm it down. For the Alolan Marowak versus Machamp matchup, what happens is with the default stats, which is most likely what you're gonna encounter out there, right? Because Alolan Marowak is quite difficult to get with like fantastic IVs, high stat product, right? If you're able to block this shadow ball, you can actually kill it, right? So just try your very best to block this shadow ball and you'll have a chance to beat it. But if your opponent, let's say, has really a god Marowak, okay, fantastic stats, it's not gonna work out. Even if you block it, it's gonna get to this shadow ball with 3 HP left, right? So it's definitely a possibility, okay? But you have to block that first shadow ball. So you have to know how to count fire spins to shadow ball, which is 6. How do you remember that? You just count the letters in shadow, right? So S-H-A-D-O-W, that's 6 fire spins to a shadow ball. Haunter versus Rhyperior is IV based, right? So this is with default stats. It's 3 HP, super close, but if you maximize, actually, I'm not so sure what you want in this cup. If you want like an attack-based Haunter to get the CMP ties, or if you want this for this matchup, right? I'm actually not sure. I guess it depends. If your team needs more Haunter coverage, if your team needs more Haunter coverage, then maybe have your Haunter have more attack. Now, the rest of the matchups are pretty clear. And as you can see, Haunter here is the best anti-fighting ghost type. But against the steel types, Haunter is really bad. Really bad, okay? So it clearly loses to Probopass and Wormadam. And for Steelix, you can actually throw straight Shadow Ball. But the thing is, it's IV based, right? So this is with default stats. You win with a lot of HP. That's really nice. But if you're battling someone with a high stat product Steelix, you're gonna lose, alright? So maximized, Steelix can actually get to the crunch that kills you. Now for the other two, Marowak and Sableye, Steelix is just a question. Can it land the Earthquake? If it can land the Earthquake, it wins. If it cannot, it loses. So from the ghost side here, the ghost angle, what you have to do is just throw straight Shadow Ball or straight Bone Club and throw straight Foul Play and block the Earthquake. So you have to know how to count Dragon Tail to Earthquake, which is 7. Okay, how do you remember 7 Dragon Tails to an Earthquake? Okay, Dragon Tail, alright, Dragon Ball, alright, Balls. How many Dragon Balls are there? There are 7 Dragon Balls, anime reference, alright? For all the weebs out there, you know this. For all the non-weebs out there, 7 Steel, Steelix 7, something like that, right? It sounds like a 7, right? So yeah, so after 7 Dragon Tails, Balok, Alolan Marowak versus Probopass is iffy if it throws, right? If Probopass throws, alright? So what you want to do is, if you're on Probopass's side is, don't throw, alright? Just don't throw, you're gonna get it 100% default, maximized, you got it, alright? It's a little bit closer, maximized, but again, Alolan Marowak is pretty hard to get with high stat product, right? So, realistically, it's gonna go more like, basically like this, okay? So, yeah, you're gonna come out with a good amount of HP. A high stat product Probopass can kill a non-body boosted Sableye straight Rock Slide, okay? So, if you wanna make this a sure thing, make your buddy Sableye, because that's gonna make it 100% sure thing, and it's a big difference, huge difference. Marowak and Sableye are tied for best anti-steel ghost. Now, the difference between Marowak and Sableye, one, the ghost type coverage. Sableye is the best ghost type slayer. For Haunter, since it's so squishy, you don't have to throw your charge attacks. You can actually just farm it down, but block once, okay? Also, if you have like a high stat product Haunter, you're gonna get to, well, I don't think that it's impossible to get to this second Shadow Punch, right? But the thing is, it's not gonna kill, right? So if you're on the side of Sableye, don't block if it gets to the second Shadow Punch, it's all good. Now with the Alolan Marowak, you definitely want to throw your charge attacks, but you don't have to worry about it getting to two Shadow Balls. It's very, very far from another Shadow Ball when it dies. Alolan Marowak here is actually the worst anti-ghost ghost type, because it loses the Haunter straight Shadow Punch. But Alolan Marowak is the best anti-fairy ghost type. So this is the difference between Sableye and Alolan Marowak. One is a very good ghost type slayer. The other is a really good fairy type slayer, and they're actually the worst of what each one is really good at. Just remember though that Clefable here is a pure fairy type, and Wigglytuff is part normal. So for Wigglytuff, you want to throw straight Bone Club, because Shadow Ball, you might actually still lose, alright? So yeah, just go straight Bone Club for Wigglytuff. And for Clefable, going straight Bone Club will do it, but going straight Shadow Ball will save you HP. You can actually do either one, depending on what your opponent, what you think your opponent might have in the back, right? So for Shadow Ball, this will leave you at around like 40 to 50 HP. Bone Club will leave you at 19 HP, alright? So if you're thinking that your opponent might have a ghost type in the back and you don't want to get farmed down, maybe go for the 19, go for the Bone Club, right? So this is not gonna give you, not gonna give the opposing ghost type much energy. Plus, you're pretty close to a Bone Club, right? Pretty close. So you might be able to throw at, let's say, Haunter if it comes in. Now for the Haunter versus Clefable matchup, what you have to do is you have to plant them balls, all right? You have to land the Shadow Ball on the Clefable. So how do you count a Shadow Ball? Let's say you're on the Clefable side, your Clefable's out there battling a Haunter. You don't want to get hit with a Shadow Ball. So how do you count it? Shadow Claw to Shadow Ball is 7. How do you remember that? Deadly Balls, all right? Deadly Balls, which is, you know, death again, once again. It's a scythe, which is shaped like 7. Deadly Balls, Ball Scythe, Deadly Scythe, Deadly Scythe Balls, just 7. Okay, okay, okay. And finally, the flying type coverage. Now, the first thing that I want you to look at here is Gliscor and Gligar, right? So for Gliscor, iffy yellow playable matches. For Gligar, it's clear. It beats the ghost, right? Straight Night Slash. Now, if you remember episode 2, which was about the steel types, you'd remember that Gliscor was a really, really good steel type slayer. Very good steel type slayer, like clear against Probopass and Steelix. But then Gligar had iffy matches, and this is kind of like their side grade type situation, right? Gliscor is a really good steel type slayer, and Gligar here is a really good ghost type slayer. Okay, okay, the strats. Now the situation with Gliscor versus the ghost types is a shootout, a block type situation, right? So for the first two, for Marowak, for Sableye, the question is, can you land the Earthquake? Okay, what's the count? Fury Cutter to Earthquake is 17. The thing is, I really don't think that it's worth it to count. Maybe just practice, get a feel for how long it takes, I guess, or something. Or, you know, if you're really meticulous, sure, count 17 for the earthquake. But with Haunter, you have to block the Shadow Ball, right? If you block the Shadow Ball, you win, which is how many Shadow Claws again? We just talked about that. How many Deadly Balls? You remember that? The Deadly Balls, Deadly Scythe, Deadly Balls, 7. Oh my god, you are getting there. You are getting to the next level. Now, the situation with Golbat over there, okay, way over there, right, is you have to block the Shadow Ball, right? Plus, it has to block your Shadow Ball, okay? So, you already know how to count that, but how do you count Wing Attack to Shadow Ball? It's so easy. Wing it, okay? So, wing 8. 8. It's 8. And that's basically it. The rest of the matches, very clear for Charizard. Go straight Shadow Ball, straight Foul Play, and then straight Shadow Punch, right? Because Shadow Punches from Haunter hurt. And Charizard is super squishy. For Skarm there, unfortunately, Sableye here can't beat Skarm, which is kind of soggy. It kind of like falls behind the other two for the flying type coverage. But for the ones with the balls, all right, with the Shadow Balls, okay, just go straight Shadow Ball. You got it. And so, if you're looking for a ghost type that can hold its own against the steel types, is a very, very good fairy type slayer and also beats Skarm, then Alolan Marowak might be the Pokemon that you're looking for. But maybe what you're looking for is a ghost type that has the best anti-steel properties with the buddy boost, because Probopass becomes a clear match and is also the best anti-ghost ghost type, then you're looking for Sableye. But maybe what you're looking for is the best anti-fighter ghost type and also beat Skarmory with its deadly balls, then Haunter is the Pokemon for you. But yeah, that's gonna be it for the video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. Oh, now it's gonna be all Patreon this, Patreon that. Look at this Patreon, look at the Patreons, right? Not until I get my Icy Wind Drifblim. If this video is helpful to you and you want to support the channel, check out my Patreon right there. And big shouts out to all these beautiful people. Thank you so much for all the support. It's like he doesn't even hear me. Icy Wind Drifblim. It's... Oh my god. Do they actually work? Check out the merch. Subscribe if you haven't yet. Ding that notification bell. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye, guys!